Hi everybody, welcome to the Laidback Show, episode 9.
This is Faisal Kapadi and Dr. Awab with me. Laidbackshow.com and twitter.com/laidbackshow. Laidback.
And now you can even search for our podcast in iTunes.
You just
have to type, go to the podcast directory in iTunes store, the app store, and type Laidback Show, and you can then subscribe.
Pakistan, Laidback Show, I think we're...
Faisal, whatever. They have all the tags there, so you can...
I think we just want to refine that. I think what I was yesterday thinking about, a video version, and we split it into an audio version, so people who don't have time to watch us can actually download it on their
iPhone. I've already uploaded the audio version.
Yeah, and I think this time we'll make sure that MP3 bhi jaye.
And I think audio would be better instead of a video. And
people
iTunes.
Who don't want, people who don't have time can plug it in.
I
do that every morning when I'm driving. I'm dropping my kid to school, so I've got this 45 minute, and I have one
sort of like our own radio show as well.
It is. I mean. I think, but you know, technology. I love technology. So every month, every week, every day, I have a technology podcast which I listen to. So it does help.
I listen to that stuff that you didn't know existed.
Oh,
have you seen that?
No, I'm asking.
The very freaky one. Anyways,
अब तो आप iPhone पे हैं भैया, तो आप तो आप जो बदमाशी करनी है कर लें.
अच्छा, Naveen and Poppy were supposed to be with us today. Very sorry that they couldn't make it. There's a VIP blockage.
Why?
So
I had some trouble. Naveen got stuck into traffic because the entire Sharif Faisal would be locked up. Imagine rush hour traffic.
Yeah.
And the people. And
she's saying bumper to bumper.
And she came on Sharif Faisal and she was turned off into Awari, behind Awari Towers. And she said, "Ab main kahan mudungi, wapas jaungi."
So as we say this, Poppy and Naveen are somewhere on Sharif Faisal piddling along, trying to get back home because of us. So we're sorry, guys. But moving on, aaj kya discuss karna hai bhai? Obama saab ki
I didn't listen. To I didn't listen to that speech, and because I kind of
okay, he kindly has given you the gist of it. He basically said, ki, "You know, I accept this award, but I have to make some hard points, and the points are that we send those 30,000 people in because." Those are the only guarantee. That is the only guarantee of peace ensured in that area. Now, I don't know about you, but I think this is bullshit. I mean,
you're talking about the peace part.
The peace part and the whole, you know. I mean,
You can't. Hey,
I think seriously, man. Everybody said when he came that you know the guy has a lot of integrity and Bush kharab tha, yeh fala fala. He was an alcoholic. Look at this guy. He's cool. He uses a BlackBerry. He's on Twitter. He's on Twitter as Barack Obama as well, and all that. And but kya kiya isne? I mean, what kind of integrity does
change.
He have? Kya change kiya?
Yes, we can.
Nothing. He hasn't changed. I mean, in America, if you speak to an American today, he's going to tell you that nothing has changed. In fact, things have gone downhill.
Obama ke saath the romance. That I also had was he talked the right talk, okay? But he did not walk the walk, right? Abhi bhi he is doing what they are doing. Acha, ye jo agar aap going bullets lekar or guns lekar aap ja rahe hain, you talking about peace? That's just stupid absurdity entire in this.
Nobel Peace Prize accept kaise kar sakte ho yaar? You tell me that. How can you accept the Nobel Peace Prize after what you've done in the last week?
He's not done it. He doesn't believe he's done. He will do it, but he actually, you know, one conference that I can, or you force a darker, I can probably bring about change. And the problem is Afghanistan say that they're talking about the fact that we are unstable. Unstability control, that's what they're doing. But I agree with you that they're talking about crap. There will be peace, nahi aayegi, aise bullets lekar, you have to do rebuilding measures, you have to empower these people. Iraq is still shooting, they keep on shooting themselves in the foot every time. They don't have an exit strategy. Abhi bhi exit strategy 3 saal aage hai, 2 saal aage hai. 2012 wale movie ke saath dekh lo.
Haan, 2012. That was saw the movie and I found it to be very cliche.
I ranked it at a
5 out of 10. I mean, American president kabhi doesn't flee the scene of the catastrophic events taking place. He always goes down to his troops, and then Arabs are always first class, and even the arcs at the end of the world, and the effects are amazing.
I think what happened was the 2012 label that was wrong because hamari abhi. imagine karna 2012 mein kuch hone, we can only foresee.
You know why they get that label? The Hopi and the Mayan culture believes, and it's in the ancient texts,
oh,
which are more than 400 years old, that the world is going to end on December
24th, 2012. Oh, there you go. So that's why, because for me, I didn't know the background,
yeah,
but for me,
so that's why
that
I gave that.
2012 ke saal. I mean, even if you're futuristic movie, if it was 2030, it would be more believable. 2012, yes, climate change, yes, global warming would make sense, but not the neutrons.
So the whole the movies are now a lot of them are featuring on these ecological disasters. And there's a new movie that's going to come out by James Cameron called The Avatar, which Shobes gave us this topic. And the previous topic, the Obama one, was given by Aisha Haq on,
yeah,
Twitter. So Shobes says that we should discuss The Avatar. Now, The Avatar is this movie, again, set in the future. I think 2052 or 3, to be precise. And what happens in that movie is that an American galactic force, I don't know why Americans are heading the galactic force every time, maybe they rule the world at that time, goes into light years away to a planet called Pandora.
Achha.
And they form clones of themselves with mixing the genes of them and the local population. They send people in, and the objective is to get hold of a mineral which will save the Earth from ecological disaster. And well, it's a James Cameron movie, most expensive film ever made till date. It's all gone,
yes,
the Titanic and everything. And
I think
Signary Weaver, the aliens,
yeah,
person, the woman is going to be there. And let's see, kya hota hai is movie mein?
Yeah, movie is entertainment fact.
But yeah, tum ye dekho, ab ye movie mein baith ke soch jata. Ab is movie mein, theek hai, jo unhone dikhaya hai. If you substitute that mineral for oil,
for oil,
theek hai, if you substitute that Naipi or jo bhi unhone culture dikhaya hai, alien from the Taliban, to afpak hi to hai yaar ye. That's what it is, you know. Think about it. I mean, it's a crazy conspiracy theory.
It's coming in December.
Yeah, it's coming. It's being released pretty soon.
Yeah.
DVD. Piracy. But think about it, man. It's like, because, you know, it's the same scenario. The US goes in,
yeah,
takes over a place, doesn't know what the hell they're doing, fucks everything up. And, you know, that's what happens in the movie as well.
Yeah, you too. But what's changing the world in a different perspective, I mean, it's a global mindset, okay, we're going to redefine the borders of the world according to what their niche is. Do you think there's a conspiracy behind all this?
Well, it's been touted throughout history.
Touted throughout history, but has
the new world order.
Yeah, has it ever changed? I mean, you know, mujhe ye batao ki main gaadi chala raha hun, jaake accident ho jata hai, to I can't blame that on the new world order. Even jo the countries fighting
well,
in wars.
Well, look, I'll give you an example. The new world, the Illuminati version of the new world order states that basically the objective is to create a vacuum. Now, how is that vacuum created? To create so much financial turmoil in the world. Okay, and now this is going to sound creepy. To create so much financial turmoil in the world that people lose faith in their governments, thus creating a vacuum of leadership.
Pakistan's
and then they implement their leadership and implant their people all over the world and they take over.
Pakistan,
look at what's happening
Pakistan,
all over the world. Every country, kisi bhi country ki population government,
so,
they hate the government.
Zardari is at the Illuminati. Yeah, he's doing something wrong. Yeah, moving on. that's a statement that can't be answered.
Well, let's just. I'm going to say is that throughout history, the world's most brilliant minds have been in the Illuminati,
yeah,
and they have been Freemasons.
Tell me about
Darwin was one.
Yeah.
Leonardo da Vinci was one. Achha, wo saab jo the Einstein, wo the George Washington. Thi. So you know there are lots of people very famous and very brilliant people. A lot of the U.S. presidents were. Not in the Illuminati, but in the Freemasonry.
Moving on.
Zahid Ahmed ki aap baat kar rahe the. Zahid Ahmed ke bare mein aapko ek funny cheez batao. A friend of mine, Uruz Zia, she's a journalist,
yeah,
you know her as
well,
a fiery person. She pointed something very funny out. Zahid Ahmed said in one of his shows that there is a hadith that instructs us to buy guns, to drive cars, and to do something else. I forgot about that. But how can a hadith talk about driving cars when there were no cars at that time?
Anyway, in fact, you know,
what is this guy?
About a week, 2 weeks back, there's a guy who published an article on a blog Ghazwatul Hind ke bare mein. Inhone bahut hadithe quote ki,
ha wo jo hadith hai,
hadithe quote ki, and he was asking me to share it as a link, and since you brought it up, I think I don't know the entire summary of it and I don't want to venture into what he said.
Wo bhi to venture karte hain,
to mere blog par 86 battle ho chuki Zaid Hamid ke khilaf. Acha, to I think I was just a little hesitant to
I think he's very convincing, but I don't see that a lot of the times he says things that don't make any sense.
Yeah, the problem with him is he is a good orator. He has motivational powers with a lot of people. He has motivated them, but the problem is what I feel he has linkages with the establishment and all that. And I don't want our youth to be misled into something.
I don't know what the linkages with the establishment.
Yeah, har waqt, I mean. I give another example. देखो आप anti-India की बात करें, anti-America की बात करें, anti-Israel की बात करें, एक दो शेर इकबाल की शेर डालें और उसको घोल कर चाय पिलाई, ऐसी तड़के की चाय मिलेगी तो वो तड़के की चाय जो है ज़ैद अहमद हर दफा हमको पिला दे.
नहीं वो ठीक है, but I mean he does have a few valid points as well. अच्छा वो है, छोड़ ज़ैद अहमद को यार, you know, let's talk about something relevant. You had something very.
I was आजकल बहुत debate चली है ना, 4-5 days the NFC award is under. A heavy discussion. Where this, I mean, right now the Dawn's headlines today was Sindh and Punjab again at a battleground and fighting.
They always have loggerheads over the distribution of resources.
And I think the thing which has to be understood is Punjab has a fertile land, and they believe that the NSC award. I'm sorry, NSC award is based on density population, on how many people, and 60% of the population based there. So they believe that all resources.
Yeah, because they're the largest provinces, so you get the most resources. But main ye believe karta hu ki resources, the Pakistan ki mulk ke jo resources hain, they should be allocated according to tax level. Jo jagah sabse zyada tax deti hai government of Pakistan ko, jahan sabse zyada income generate hota hai government of Pakistan ke liye, us jagah ko pehle priority milni chahiye in distribution of resources. And I'm not saying this because I live in Karachi and I'm a Sindhi. But the fact is, I think we pay like 62% of the country's tax, and we get judged.
Well, that's also probably the Republican and Democratic difference also. Where the rich end up paying lesser. Republicans are ulti kahani. Rich end up paying lesser taxes, while poor pay more taxes.
I'm not saying don't give resources to Balochistan and to the more rural areas, but I'm saying that, you know, at least give up, at least prioritize the resource giving. कि भाई, you know, इस जगह ने इतने पैसे हमको दिए, तो let's just invest at least what they've given back to them, you know. फिर बाकी जो बाकी सब ने दिया है
उसके ऊपर बलूचिस्तान का तो वो नहीं होता कि they're making whatever revenues they're generating, they're not getting even that share.
And I agree with them, because yeah. You see, ever since देखें जो सारी companies हैं बड़ी, they've been pumping the oil fields and the gas fields and Sui and all that, Sibi and Baloch, I mean, all these Baloch resources being used. And the people of Balochistan are very backward, bichare. They have got no royalties. And this government has actually taken a very good step of now stating that they're going to give them the royalties since 1954, I think. Ab pata nahi usme amal kitna hota
hai.
But at least, yaar, pehli baar kisi ne jo hai wo aake unko at least ye bola ki haan hum aapko dein.
Achha, and
there's been a proper parliamentary action.
You brought about Balochistan issue. I mean, I have some discussion.
You're going to Balochistan tomorrow.
I am Hingol off-roading karne ja raha, and I don't know if my car will be fixed up. I've been gayi hai 3 months.
Is that the wife's conspiracy?
It must be. Yeah, two three days se yehi debate chali, battle chali.
How do you do it, man? How do you go in those mountains and kya maza milta hai? I mean, I think it's freedom.
Abhi to aajkal sardi mausam acha hai, to we definitely have a campfire, enjoy it. But I think literally ye haal hota hai ki mera mobile off ho jata hai.
Wow.
And you have nothing to do.
Isn't that scary, man? I'm a very creature comfort kism ka guy. I can't like go in the wild and do this. I can't somehow imagine myself doing that.
Mitti bahut hai. I mean, if you talk about the level of discomfort, it's tremendous. I mean, tremendous. Mitti aap kha rahe because
I'm alright with roughing it. But to have no facilities.
You're talking about the toilet facilities.
A toilet or a shower.
Pura Balochistan, jahan turn your behind around anywhere and just do it.
That's not right.
What do you mean, yaar?
That's not right.
You've been modernized. Do it in that capsule.
Like I said, I've got. I'm a creature of comfort. I don't. I don't enjoy, you know, going in the bushes.
Or the porta potties.
Yeah, it's just that, you know, I mean, why would I put myself in that position?
I think it's probably a personal issue, which I mean, personal in the sense that I'm
more cool with the comfort part, the freedom part, and the, I mean, I'm sure it's very inspiring.
Look,
and then you've shown me some pictures.
What I've enjoyed is the freedom of the policy, but there's a price to pay for the freedom also. Price to pay in the sense you don't get a comfortable bed every time. And you don't get a machar bug cutting you and all those.
I don't machar cut any. I'm immune to that. They don't bite me.
Pee pocket.
They can't handle the blood.
I eat outside. I probably the problem was the bathroom, and that was it. But once you, it's a mental block which you just.
It is not a mental block. It's just civilization, man, and you're like. Going against it, you're like, you know,
But it's we go with the club called the offeredpakistan.com, and it's a group of about 10. This time, I think we got a car, about 11 cars going in, and really huffing it.
What do you do there?
Well, we actually just take a
small joints.
Nothing at all. This is absolutely no drinking.
No substance abuse.
Nothing at all. So, main postal address, we just make a right on a certain patti, pagdandi. And
if there's no substance abuse, how do you reach Nirvana in the mountains?
You do.
What
just
do
sitting
mean?
There, it's so beautiful, peaceful. We got a moonless night also.
Okay.
So, I think we'll have a good time looking at stars, and you can't imagine
the stars.
Just stay
away from the fucking wolves, okay?
Then
they're like wild animals.
In fact, the lake that we swim in has live alligators.
Very nice. Takes up pictures for us.
Yes, absolutely.
Achha, what about, speaking of people going to remote areas, what about all this jihadi tourism that's going on these days? And the five people that were caught from Sankhuda, which are American Muslims. Why are people engaging in these things?
Dekho,
five guys from Washington, D.C.
Texas mein ek cult hua. Remember in So can't you have that? I mean, there's so America with many cults where fanatical thinking goes on. It doesn't have to be always Islam. It doesn't.
I'm saying this because ye Muslims the. Five American Muslims the. And they had they put up some YouTube videos, and then they were contacted by some militant called Saifullah. And Saifullah invited them. Oh yeah, you have my backpack and laptop with all the
yarn. Well, that's the spirit of adventurism also. Just to find out
what's crazy.
It is. As I said, I'm not saying that these Joe fundamentalists of fanatical thinking. And that's why the point why I raised Waco, Texas was the fact that kahini fanatism ban sakti. It's not Pakistan, it's not Afghanistan. People in America, you would be surprised there are hundreds of thousands of people who actually conspire against the government. That ye hamare khilaf ye kaam kar rahi. The whites. They've got so many conspiracy theories going on.
Small
section being Muslim, non-Muslim, Christian, Jews, they can be recruited into a network and brought over for tourism, for the heck of tourism, and ultimately arrested.
So you think that they might not have come for the purpose of jihad? Is that what you're saying?
They potentially could be converted into jihadists.
So they just came to see what the fuck is going on.
Absolutely. I'm not saying this.
I can imagine you're insane enough to try that.
I give an example. If I'm so pushed to a cause which I believe in, and if someone says, ki bhai, aake dekho, and I have the finances to buy a ticket.
But I mean, they watch the news, they know what's going on. It's not like they're unaware of what's going on.
But understand the fact. I mean, news is entirely, and half the time we even criticize our own media. And being pulled into it with knowing the hazards of going to Pakistan of all places and getting stuck there. So I think it's valid order.
But what they're doing is a criminal act in Pakistan. Aren't they aware of that? These militants are killing us. So I mean, we're fighting a war against them. Our war. Let me just state very clearly.
Absolutely.
And these people are coming from outside to help the militants. It's like me going to America and saying, oh yeah, you know, I'm going to help David Koresh fuck you up. That's not right, man. And these are our brother Muslims that are doing this. So, you know, we just want to give a message out to all our brother Muslims out there. You know, chill out, man. You know,
It's not about war of Islam, it's not a crusades versus the Moro or whatever,
this is not what's going on. So, you know, if you like helping that side, you're actually going against us. So please chill out, stay where you are, and, you know, lead a normal life.
Well, I forgot, one of our viewers said English about that movie.
I'm English about that movie.
Last time we actually did the entire show in English.
I think we did.
So anyway, Urdu transcript with that.
Urdu transcription kya hota hai? I think we speak a mixture. We speak English. We speak both.
I think when he commented that, I thought ki if you deliberately do something, it just will sound artificial. Even if we get into stream, kya humne Urdu English mein bolna hai.
If I start talking like this, then that's artificial something.
Moving on. Bank of Punjab ka jo absconder tha.
He's a defaulter. What is he doing?
Lab issued an order, an arrest warrant. And the US government has reciprocated and arrested him there in Washington.
Right.
And so-called NAB has said that he would be extradited back to Pakistan.
Cool, na? What's wrong with that?
Imagine yaar ye bande corruption karke chhod chhad ke dusre mulk mein jaake rehte hain, and wahan hamari
the story of Edgware Road, man. The story of Edgware Road, that most of the biggest houses and apartments in Edgware Road are owned by ex servicemen, by ex bureaucrats.
Coming back to episode 6, where you quoted Transparency International saying that Pakistan Army DHA mein plots ki corruption kam hai, magar army wale wahan bhi baithe
hain. Nahi, main ye keh raha tha. No, listen, I think army mein bhi hogi corruption, but I think corruption is more possible in arms dealings and contracts than it is in that sector of our economy, because I don't see any corruption about that. Yet I know that if I'm selling submarines to Pakistan, it's a general impression, and everybody knows that whatever kickback will come. It's not just Pakistan, Sri Lanka, India, all of these people. You know, I mean, there's a reason why Israel is such good friends with India. They send them so many arms. They make so much money off them, and obviously they give kickbacks to somebody.
I was thinking about talking about ye jo aajkal aaj ki aaj bahut hefty debate hui Faisal Qureshi ke saath.
I don't want to talk about it.
but I think it's important to note ke the new media, with all its reservation, has to be left untouched.
I think it was some sort of a misunderstanding between me and him, and the point I was trying to make was that he said in his program on the 8th of December ke jo hai main internet pe log
nahi
chahte rehte hain
ye nahi aata
aur woh aate nahi hai, and he says now he was talking about 20 people who wanted him to do a special show for them and none of them showed up. So I mean, I can understand why he's getting pissed off about that, but he used the word civil society several times, and I was like, bhai, you know, we write blogs, I write in the Friday Times, we do the show every week. What can we do? Coming on TV is not the be all and end all of expressing your opinion.
Even TV1 and these channels don't repeat guests so frequently because they don't want one opinion. I have seen, and I would love ke bahut sare hamare bloggers bhi itne capable ho jaye ki wo jaake TV par aaram se baat kare. There's a very small section of bloggers who do that.
Her talk show host, jo hai, except for the people who are related to tech or a specific issue, ek hi baat karta hai. Woh NRO ki baat karega. Aajkal terrorism mein kya ho raha hai? Aajkal mulk ke halaat kahan ja rahe hain? Aapka education ke bare mein kya khayal hai? You know, and once you've gone and expressed your opinion on that,
It's a matter of record now.
फायदा नजर नहीं आता, पूरी दुनिया यही कर रही है. ki sare talk shows wale baith ke yahi keh rahe the to I don't see that. Anyways, you know, I mean, whatever it was, we cleared it up, and it's good to have debate because at least you get to know the other person's point of view, and you get to.
I think we got a crowd coming in. Like, yes, you could hear them all around the place.
So let's have a big show quickly before they turn back in this place. Alright, this is me, Faisal Kapadia, Nawab Ali,
signing off on the 9th episode of the Laidback Show.
Thank you.
And thank you, and keep the feedback coming. I think we just have to organize our topic discussions more organized way. And see you now.
See you. And have a good weekend and drive safe.
Ingol.
Ingol. I think we